نحمده ونسلي ونسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد رسوله النبي الأمين المكين الحنين الكريم الرؤوف الرحيم. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون، الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون، صدق الله مولانا العظيم. Dear viewers, I welcome you to another episode of Friends of Allah on ARYQ-TV, a program that is devised to discuss the life and the teachings of the Awliya Allah, the friends of Almighty Allah, those that are an expert on the spiritual excellence, those that are an expert on the science of tazkiyah, on the science of self-purification. Dear viewers, in this episode, the life and the teachings that we will be discussing are of a great Sufi saint, of a great friend of Almighty Allah, who was known for his pious personality and was in fact one of the most distinguished Sufis of his time. In regards to his muqam, another famous great friend of Allah who lived in the same time, Sirri Saqati rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he says that whatever I have attained, what the muqam, the spiritual status that I am enjoying and Allah Almighty has blessed me with, whatever I have is because of this great Sufi saint. And who is this great Sufi saint? He is Abu Mahfuz Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, who is commonly known as Ma'ruf Karkhi. Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi alayhi was that great friend of Almighty Allah that went through many hardship, difficulties, trials and challenges in his life. But despite he remained firm in his love for Almighty Allah, in his dedication for Almighty Allah, in the obedience of Almighty Allah, his trial started from the time that he did not yet accept Islam. He was born into a Christian family, so he was a convert to Islam, or as some may say, he was a revert to Islam, both which have the same meaning. Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi's father, Feroz, he and his whole family, they were Christians. Hazrat Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, from an early age, did not accept the teachings of Christianity, particularly the concept of thalasa, the concept of Trinity, is something that he could not accept and something that he was not comfortable with. When at a young age he was sent to the school, to the religious school, and the teacher taught him, and the teacher said, "Oh Ma'ruf, say that God is one of the three." Sayyid Ma'ruf, Sheikh Ma'ruf Al-Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, said, "La, no, huwallahu ahad, he is one." This had such an impact, and the teacher expressed his anger towards Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi in such a way that not only did he beat him, at the same time Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi's parents were upset with him. His parents tried to persuade him, tried to influence him, tried to take out that concept of oneness of Almighty Allah from his mind through many ways, but they were unsuccessful. In fact, the last attempt that they made to let this Ma'ruf Al-Karkhi accept the concept of Trinity and reject the concept of Tawheed, the last attempt they made to their own son was they locked him up in the room for 3 days. And for 3 days, they used to give him some food. But on the fourth day, when they opened the room, Ma'ruf Karkhi, that young child, had not touched the food that he was given for the past 3 days. So they were surprised. They were surprised that despite that he did not eat for 3 days, still he looked energetic. Still he did not look weak, as it did not reflect from his physical appearance that he had not eaten. And they asked him, "Oh Ma'ruf, why did you not eat this food? And how come that you are not looking weak?" And Ma'ruf Al-Karkhi replied that the one that I believe in, he is the one who is the best provider and who is the best provider of provisions. And he has provided me Allahu yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab, and he gives to his servants without any means. He does not need any mean, and he gives without any counting, bighayri hisab. After this, Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi left his home and he went outside, and for many days he did not return home. And his parents then sent a message, because they found out where he was, and the message was that, "Oh, our son, come back home, and we have no problems now, and we will not stop you from accepting the message of Islam." So Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi then came home. The dedication of Ma'ruf al-Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, the strong will of Ma'ruf al-Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, had such an impact on the parents of Ma'ruf al-Karkhi that they also then accepted Islam. They became Muslims also. After this, Hazrat Ma'ruf al-Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, his shahada, by the way, he accepted Islam on the hands of the great member, noble member of the Ahlul Bayt family, Imam Ali Rida. In fact, Hazrat Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala, according to one narration, his parents used to work for Hazrat Imam Ali Rida. However, I find it difficult to accept this narration and tradition, and this is a narrative, and this is due to the fact that how could someone like his parents be in the company of Imam Ali Rida for so many years and yet not accept Islam? And the noble members of the Ahlul Bayt are those that whose life, whose kindness, compassion, and whose generosity was known and was recognized and acknowledged and had left always an impact on the people. Hazrat Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi then went to one of his shuyukh, and he spent time in the company of many shuyukh of his time. First and foremost, Hazrat Imam Ali Rida. But then another great Sufi in whose company he used to sit was Ibn Samak. And Ibn Samak is a teacher who gave him once an advice, and the advice was that, "Oh Ma'ruf, whatever you do, never dislike those that are poor, those that are fuqara, those that are people that are poor and deprived from the worldly wealth. Do not dislike them. In fact, associate with them. In fact, be kind to them. In fact, sit with them." And Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi accepted this advice, and throughout his life, he used to always consider the poor. He used to always sit in the company of the poor, and he used to always be extra kind to the poor. And he himself would not eat. He himself would not eat the food that he had bought with his own belongings until he would sit in the company. He would sit in the company of those that are deprived of the fuqara. And among them, he would then share his food, and then he would have his own meal. When Hazrat Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi passed away, someone saw him in the dream, and he was sitting under the throne of Almighty Allah. And he was sitting while he had white clothes, and his clothes and his physical appearance was illuminating. And he was asked, "Oh Ma'ruf, what did Allah Almighty do with you?" And he replied, "Allah Almighty forgave my sins." And they asked, "Ma'ruf, how come your sins were forgiven? Was it because of the good deeds you did? Was it because of that obedient life that you had spent in the world? Was it because of your dedication?" And Ma'ruf al-Karkhi said, "No, it was not. Neither one of them were the reasons why I was forgiven. The reason why Allah forgave Ma'ruf Karkhi was because Ma'ruf used to love the poor people. Because of his love for those that are deprived, because of that, Allah Almighty forgave me." Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, his muqam can be understood through this narration that Muhammad ibn Mansur al-Tusi rahmatullahi alayhi once saw Hazrat Ma'ruf al-Karkhi, and he had a scar on his face, and he asked him that, "Oh Ma'ruf, oh Sheikh, yesterday when I saw you, you did not have this scar on your face, and today you have a scar. How come you have a scar? What happened in the meantime?" Hazrat Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi did not reply to him, and he again said, "Oh Sheikh, I am observing a scar on your face, and you didn't have it yesterday. Tell me what happened. How did you get that scar on your face?" And then Hazrat Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi replied, Don't ask me about this. Only ask me about that that is beneficial for you, that is profitable for you. And then Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala was again asked. And then he replied, he said, that since you have been asking me this so many times now, let me tell you, but keep this a secret until I die. And he said that yesterday, before I sleeping, I wished that I could do the tawaf of the house of Almighty Allah. I wished that I could be in the presence of the Holy Kaaba. And then Allah Almighty gave me the presence of the Kaaba. That night, last night, I spent in the company of the Kaaba. I spent in the mutaf while I was doing the tawaf. And this was physically, this was the distance between his city and between Makkatul Mukarramah was thousands of miles. And Maruf Karkhi says that while I completed my tawaf and I read the nafal, the two nafal, I then wanted to drink some zamzam water. And I went towards the well of zamzam. There my foot got struck and I fell down. While I fell down, my face struck the well. And this is how I got the scar. So Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi was one of those awliya whose karamat is that they were able to be in various different muqamats at one time, or they were at the same time, they were able to shorten the distances of the world. They could be at a place that is hundreds and thousands of miles away in a few moments, in a few seconds. And this in fact is a quality of some of the friends of Almighty Allah, one of the karamat of the friends of Almighty Allah, which is that they are blessed with the tayyi zamani and tayyi makani, that they can be at a different place or they can be at the same time in different places, or they can be at one time in a different particular muqam. The character, the personality of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi was that he was a very pious and very dedicated servant of Almighty Allah, like all of the awliya and all of the friends of Almighty Allah. Sirri Saqati, rahmatullahi alayhi, a great Sufi saint, a friend of Allah, and contemporary of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi, he says, whatever I have attained, all the blessings, the barakat, the spiritual enlightenment that I have is through the means, through the wasila of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. And how did this actually happen? This happened in this way, that Sirri Saqati rahmatullahi alayhi says, once it was the day of Eid, and I saw Maruf Karkhi, I saw my Shaykh. At that time I did not become his disciple. At that time he was not my Shaykh. But I saw that on the day of Eid, when everybody was enjoying the day of Eid and spending the time with his family, and everybody was taking a day off, I saw Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi plucking dates from the trees. And I asked him that since it is the day of Eid, why are you working on this day? And Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi alayhi says that I do not have any money with me and I wish to get some money. And he was asked, why do you want money? What is it that you require? Can I help you? And Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullah alayhi said, no, I don't want wealth for myself. In fact, look there. Look at that orphan child that is sitting at the street. That orphan child is not wearing any nice clothes. That orphan child did not have any good food today. And there is no one that is looking after him. When I saw this child, I wanted to do something for him. I wanted to help him. And because of this, I started working on the day of Eid so I could earn some halal income. And then from that income, I could buy clothes for the child. I could buy not only clothes, also food for the child. Sirri Saqati rahmatullah alayhi, who did not yet become the disciple of Maruf Karkhi, he was a wealthy man. And he then said that, let me take care of this. And he went to the child and he bought him the clothes, he bought food for him and took him home with him. And Hazrat Maruf Karkhi also joined them. Hazrat Sirri Saqati says that when I looked after this orphan, this is something that caused so much pleasure to me that suddenly my condition changed, my state of the heart changed. And he says that night when I slept, on that night Allah Almighty gave me that barakat, those blessings, and Allah Almighty gave me his proximity, he gave me his closeness, he gave me his qurba and his nearness, so much that I had never ever experienced that nearness before. And he says that Almighty Allah blessed me with spiritual enlightenment, and that was also through the barakat of Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. And Sirri Saqati until this moment was a pious man, until this moment was an obedient servant of Almighty Allah. He would worship Allah Almighty, he would fulfill the commandments, the faraid, but despite that, he did not yet attain spiritual excellence. Despite that, the nur, the barakat did not enter his heart. But the moment that he looked after that orphan, the moment he took care of a creation of Almighty Allah, that is the same moment that Allah Almighty then granted him spiritual enlightenment. Allah Almighty then made a light, nur, enter the heart of Sirri Saqati rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. And Sirri Saqati says, this all happened because of the wasila of Ma'ruf Karkhi. Would Ma'ruf Karkhi not be there, not have been present, and this particular incident, if it would not have happened, then I would not have gone through spiritual enlightenment. And dear viewers, here a very important note is that spiritual enlightenment is not something that you gain through only the ibadah, through only worshipping Almighty Allah. Worshipping Almighty Allah helps towards it, but it is not only the ibadat that will give you spiritual enlightenment. Unless you love the creation of Allah, unless you take care of the creation of Allah, unless you take the burdens from the creation and put these burdens on your own shoulders, until that moment, you will not attain spiritual enlightenment. When we look into the life of the friends of Allah, whether this is Khawaja Mu'inuddin Chishti Ajmeri rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, Khawaja Nizamuddin Awliya, Shaykh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani, any friend of Almighty Allah, look into their lives, and the greatest friend of Almighty Allah is none except than the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. It's our beloved messenger of Almighty Allah. The way also he looked after the creation of Almighty Allah, particularly those that are deprived, particularly those that are struck with poverty. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said that love the poor people, because the poor people are those that will enter paradise first on the day of judgment. After the day of judgment has taken place and the Ahlul Jannah will be commanded to enter Jannah, the first people to enter Jannah under my guidance and the first people that under my leadership that will follow me into Jannah, into paradise, will be those that in this dunya will be poor. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say it will be those that will spend the whole night in nawafil, those that do qiyamul layl whole night. No, he said these will be the people that look after the creation of Allah. They look after the poor people, and whatever Allah has given them, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, they spend it in the way of Almighty Allah. They share it with those that do not have it. One day, dear viewers, Ma'ruf Al-Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi's friends asked him the following: What is it that has caused you to abstain from the dunya and from the creation of Allah? O Ma'ruf, is it because you prolong to the paradise and the palaces and the blessings in the paradise? Or, O Ma'ruf, is it because you are afraid of the punishments in the hereafter? What is it that has caused you to detach yourself from the dunya, to abstain from the world and the creation? And Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi then said, he said, oh my friends, these things that you are discussing are minor things. They have no meaning. In front of Almighty Allah, all these things do not have any worth. They are nothing compared to Almighty Allah. When Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi prays, he does not pray for Jannah. He does not pray because he is afraid of the hell. Ma'ruf Karkhi has not detached himself from the dunya and has not dedicated his life for his Lord Almighty Allah. He does not spend his time in Allah's obedience, in Allah's ibadah, because he is prolonging and he is desiring for the Jannah and the blessings and all the great favors of Allah in paradise. And neither does he do this because he is afraid of the punishments of hereafter. He says these are just humble things in front of Almighty Allah. He says, I pray because I prolong to Allah. I desire to be in the company of Allah. I desire to be in the sohbah of Almighty Allah. And Maruf Karkhi then said, and let me tell you, once you have tasted the sohbah, tasted the great taste of the lazza of the ibadat of Almighty Allah, to be in the company of Almighty Allah and to be in His closeness, he says, then you will forget the paradise and you will forget hell. Yani, when you start understanding the beautiful, important, significance of the company of Almighty Allah, and you will taste the pleasure of the closeness of Almighty Allah, you will forget each and everything. And this is why Allama Iqbal, the famous poet, said that do alam se karti hai begana dil ko ajab cheez hai lazzat-e ashnai. Once you have tasted the love of the proximity of Almighty Allah, the nearness of Almighty Allah, the closeness of Almighty Allah, then you will forget everything what is in the world and what is in the hereafter. You will only remember Almighty Allah. Dear viewers, inshallah, we will continue our discussion on the life of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi in our next episode. Until our next episode, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Oh,